The Nambu-Goto action describes the propagation of a one-dimensional object, a string, through spacetime. This is a beautiful generalization of the zero-dimensional case for the point particle. For the point particle, the action is given by minus a parameter, the mass, times the integral along its world line. So for a one-dimensional object, we will do the same. However, we will replace the mass with another parameter, t. And the one-dimensional integral along the world line now becomes a two-dimensional integral over a world sheet. We describe the world sheet with two variables, sigma and tau. Sigma can only take on values between 0 and L, where L is the length of the string. It tells us where exactly on the string we are. And tau can have values between tau I and tau f, representing the initial and final times of the propagation. If the world sheet of the string were perfectly flat, the infinitesimal area element, dA, would just be d2 sigma. However, since we cannot assume that the string is always perfectly flat, we are integrating over a region that is not flat everywhere. For example, if we consider a closed string, the world sheet looks like a cylinder. Therefore, we have to include the square root of the determinant of the metric on the world sheet. This makes the integral coordinate independent, since the root of the metric determinant is equivalent to the Jacobian determinant when we perform a coordinate transformation. So now we are faced with the question, what is the metric on the world sheet? The answer? We get an induced metric from the surrounding Minkowski space. Remember that the functions x mu are depending on sigma and tau, and therefore are functions from the world sheet onto the Minkowski space. And there, we have a metric, the Minkowski metric eta. The induced metric on the world sheet that we inherit from the Minkowski metric is defined as the partial derivatives of x with respect to the world sheet coordinates times the Minkowski metric. So the action is given by minus t times the integral over d2 sigma over the square root of minus the determinant of the induced metric. If we plug in the expression for gamma, we can write the action in a slightly nicer way, where a dot represents a derivative with respect to tau, and a prime denotes a derivative with respect to sigma. This is the Nambu-Goto action for a string. Finally, let's talk about this parameter, t. T is called string tension, and is the only dimensionful quantity in string theory. Sometimes people use a different parameter, called regislope. The string tension and the regislope are inversely proportional to each other. Other parameters that are sometimes used are the so-called string length scale, L, and the string mass scale, M. But that's pretty much it for this video. Thanks for watching.